Guys and girls, Captain Fraser here with Flying Fish TV, and today I picked up the Flyman fly tying kit. This is a glass minnow, the guide fly, and it has everything you need in this package to complete 6 glass minnows. The reason why I picked this up, and we're going to tie this today, is I believe this might just be the ticket to some snook and tarpon that I found in Everglades National Park that are eating on some bait fish that are about the same size and color. They're actually like Mayan cichlids. And so we got this little hot pink chartreuse type deal here. We might modify this a little bit, but I think this kit is pretty cool. Wanted to try it out, never seen it before. It's been out a couple of years, I guess, since after COVID. And what's really cool is since the supply chain, you get everything you need right here in one package to be able to complete the fly. So that's a real nice idea. All right, we'll get to it. And then afterwards, we'll go try it out on these tarpon and snook, probably in part 2. So stay tuned, here we go. All right guys, first thing we're gonna do is do a thread wrap on here. Wrap down the shank. All right, what I did was I went ahead and took the tubing that they provided and I pre-cut it down into 6 equal lengths so that, you know, there's no waste or you don't get the size wrong, because these are supposed to be 3-inch flies. So I cut those ahead of time. Now we're going to go ahead and put the marabou inside the tube to length. All right, what we're going to do is place the tubing and the marabou, place it inside, and we're going to go ahead and put that on top of the shank, tie that in strongly, some nice securing wraps. Say that's probably good there. Now we're gonna go ahead and select a section of the Sanyo's laser dub and create a stack of that to make a more uniform top and length here for a second. Right now we've got Hurricane Ian coming in, so I figured it was a good time to tie some flies while the weather's foul, so that as soon as it clears up we're ready to go. And, be ready to hit that backcountry, get some of these snook and tarpon. I'm pretty excited about the prospect of this. I'm pretty sure this fly is going to work well. It's about the right size, and I think it's going to work. All right, once we've got it stacked neatly, wrap it around our thread, pull it up, tie that in a small clump. Loose wraps on there first, and then tie that, spread it around like a veil around the shank. Once we're happy with that, we'll go ahead and put some more wraps around. Ahead and Ed, start adding in the belly. I think what I'm gonna do here is probably I'm gonna add a little bit of belly flash in here, since we're talking about these snook are in pretty fresh water. Again, this is Hurricane Ian going by. We've got tornado watch for mainland Monroe County. Okay. Anyway, these snook are feeding on some freshwater forage bait here, and probably Mayan cichlids by the looks of it. It's primarily what's around there. So go ahead and put some a little bit more red in here, maybe even some bars, but we'll see what happens here. As we start to fish the fly, maybe we can add some bars with the mar. Well, looks like we're pretty good there. Go ahead and add a little flash in here. A little gill flash here, because these Mayans have a little bit of a red belly here that pokes out. And right underneath the gill, it's a little fiery red. It's a pretty neat looking fish. So, that position just right underneath the whip finish this one. We add a little plume. That set up. Then we'll go ahead and add the skull with the eyes here. We'll put a little reattach the thread behind the hook eye here, and make a little thread dam. Nice. Looks pretty cool. All right, guys, here's the completed fly. Super excited. We're going to go out to the Everglades in the Ginu on the backcountry trip, and we're going to try this sucker out. I hope they like it. Let's go and find out.